The city has a crime on its hands that's costing taxpayers tens of thousands of dollars. Vandals are killing trees around the island, and the number of cases has spiked in the past few months. Breanne Randall found out which neighborhoods are being targeted. Breanne?
Joe, the worst by far is a tree in Mililani. Well, it was a tree until someone decided to destroy it, and the person responsible knew exactly what they were doing. The city hopes someone turns them in.
Take one look at this monkey pod tree and you can see why Mililani residents enjoy Kipapa Neighborhood Park. So why would someone want to get rid of one of these great green beauties? But that's just what happened.
But I just live right across the street and my family utilizes this park regularly. And so I can tell you that the community is very upset and disappointed by this incident.
Over the past 18 months, someone has been hacking away at the bark of this tree, little by little killing it. It's called girdling and essentially cuts off the tree's ability to get nutrients.
This is probably the worst that we've seen ever. Somebody worked really hard to make sure that this tree died. If you look at the size of the wound as we go up there, they went completely around.
There have been 9 other acts of vandalism against city trees in the past 6 months, including here on Sierra Drive. This is where a tree once stood, and now all that's left is dirt. The cases started popping up in February, from Waianae to Waipahu to Waimanalo. This monkey pod was over 20 years old and valued at $19,000. City crews had to cut it down for public safety, all at taxpayer expense.
This, in my mind, is a burning of money. So we not only lose the value of a tree, but we're now wasting resources on something that we shouldn't have to do.
It hurts our budgets in the city. It hurts our parks budgets when we have to redirect monies towards these kinds of crimes.
The city has charged someone in the past with felony property damage for destroying a tree. If you catch a vandal in the act, call 911. Breanne Randall, KHON 2 News.